Hi everybody, Susumi here. I just wanted to share some tips about seeing shapes in the electron density cloud in Foldit. We are looking at puzzle number 1152. This is the extended chain that we were given at the beginning of the puzzle, and the only thing I've done to it is to shake it. I'm going to slide over to the end where the electron density cloud is, and I'm going to move my camera focus to this end of the backbone. I'm going to put my mouse on the backbone and hit Q. That just sets that point as my focus so I can turn things around easier. And I'm going to move this backbone into the middle of the cloud because that's going to give me visibility inside the cloud. Let's zoom in a bit. Well, we'll zoom in this way. I'm going to put my mouse on the backbone and hit Shift Q. This is going to zoom in and also cut away some of the cloud to make the inside more visible. Okay, so before the cloud was just a solid mass, and now you can start to see spaces in it, but there's still more cloud than I want here, so I'm going to cut away some of the background and the foreground. Remember, we used Shift Q to zoom in and cut away some of the cloud. Now we're going to cut away some more cloud. To cut away some of the background, I'm going to do Shift Control Drag on the background. And this can increase or decrease background. We're going to decrease the amount of background that we're seeing. And to decrease the foreground, we're going to use Control-Alt-Drag to just make less foreground visible. And I'm going to zoom out a little bit and see what I can see now. We're just looking at a slice right through the middle of the cloud, and we're able to do that because we put the protein in the middle of the cloud. Okay, immediately I see some long strands, this one right here and this one right next to it, of continuous backbone. Before we can mark those, we need to open the electron density menu, which is Shift E for electron density. Let's just look at the settings on this. The threshold is the most important. I have my threshold set right above the M in mouse. There's a little place here where it says press tab with mouse, and the M in mouse is right where I want to put my threshold slider. I have my alpha, which is transparency, set a little to the right of the middle. And I'm using the solid electron density. Later we'll use wireframe. Right now we're using solid because I find that's easiest to see the backbone. Okay, so I've got these long continuous strands from the top to the bottom that are parallel to one another, and those are going to be sheets because they're mostly straight. They're kind of zigzaggy, which sheets are, but they're long and mostly straight, and they're parallel to each other. So I'm going to mark those. Looks like this one starts up here. I'm going to put a dot here. I put my mouse on the cloud. I hit tab to place a dot. You can't actually see the dot because I cut away the foreground. Let me slide that back a little bit. There we go. Now the dot is visible, and I use red, so I'm going to change the color. Put my mouse on the dot, right click, and I can choose a new color for the dot. I like to use red for sheets. So there's one end of the sheet. This is quite a long sheet, so I'm going to mark the middle as well. Tab for a dot, right click for the color. And how far down does that go? Looks like it continues to about here. So I'm going to put a final dot, change the color. That'll be my first sheet marked. And then just to the left of it, there's another strand that's parallel to it. I'm rolling this forward and back so that I can see where the beginning of the strand is. Looks like it's about here. I'm going to mark that with a dot. It's a long sheet, so I'm going to put one in the middle as well. And looks like this one goes down to, here's where it starts to curve away. So I'm going to say this is the end of the sheet. I'll put a dot there. You can see I'm rolling things in and out of view. Remember, we've cut away a lot of background and foreground, so there's just a narrow slice through the cloud that we're looking at, and we have to roll things in and out of view. Now I see another sheet to the right here. Let's see if we can get, there we go. A short one on the right. Where does that one start? Right up here. I'm going to put a dot. Again, my dot is not entirely visible because it's in the foreground. So I just roll it back a little bit so I can see it. Where does that sheet end? Right about here, it curls away. So I'm looking for these long, continuous, mostly straight sections that are parallel to one another. So we've got one on the right. Let's go look on the left. I think I saw another one. There it is. Going up and down. Let me get my existing ones in view if I can. Okay, so these are the two that I marked first, and just to the left of them, there's another one. Where does that one start? Maybe right here. And how far down does it go? They don't make a perfectly flat surface. The surface of a sheet is a bit twisted. So that's why I'm having to roll them a bit to find them. Okay, this looks like the bottom of that fourth sheet. Okay, so I've found and marked four sheets in the cloud. Just so we can see them a bit better, I'm going to put my mouse on the background, on the backbone, and hit Shift Q again. That's going to give me my foreground and background back that I had cut out. That lets me see more at one time. So I've got my four sheets marked there. And it turns out that this protein is predicted to have four sheets in it. So just putting the four sheets that are predicted on the protein into the four sheets marked in the cloud is a good start for building a protein that will match the cloud. How do we figure out which sheet goes where? Well, the length is a clue. I had two long ones and two shorter ones. But we're going to look for an even better clue. We're going to look for some side chains. Before we do that, I just want to say a couple of more things about these dots. The first is we've got a crowd of red dots, and I don't want to forget what they're for. I know they're for sheets, but I don't want to forget which sheet goes with which dot. So I actually went through and added notes to these. To add a note, you put your mouse on the dot and you hit Tab, and this little point information window pops up. The note that I added to this one is sheet one. You just type your note in here. If I wanted to get rid of a dot, I would do the same thing. Put your mouse on the dot, hit Tab, this little window pops up, and there is a green recycle bin over here on the right. If you click the recycle bin, that will delete the dot. But I've gone through and added notes to all these dots indicating which sheet they went to. I just numbered the sheets left to right, 1 through 4. And let's see what that does for me. I'm going to zoom out. Okay, so I've got all my foreground and background back. Let's zoom in a bit. And when I'm ready to actually put the protein sheets into the cloud sheets, I'm going to turn off the cloud. I've got all my dots visible, and I can go into modes and note mode, and it'll turn on all of my notes. And I'll be able to see which dots go to sheet one, which dots go to sheet two. And you remember I said that sheets don't make flat surfaces, they make curved surfaces. I can see already that these sheets are bent. The sheet number three starts in the back there, comes over here to the middle, and then it actually ends over here. Not a straight line. It's in front of and above the end of sheet two. So when you're putting your sheets in to match your dots, don't be afraid to put a cut right in the middle of the sheet and just bend it at that spot so that you can fit it accurately to the cloud. Okay, tune in to the next video and we will go hunting for some side chains to use as landmarks. And thanks everyone for watching.